Hello and welcome to Bangladesh Today. I am Smita Prakash. Relations between Bangladesh and Pakistan have steadily nosedived over the past week after Pakistan's National Assembly passed a resolution strongly condemning the execution of former al-Badr and later Bangladeshi Jamaat Assistant Secretary General Abdul Quader Mollah, who was hanged in Dhaka. Mullah was convicted by the War Crimes Tribunal for committing crimes against humanity during the 1971 Liberation War. Quite naturally, Bangladeshis want to know why the Pakistan Assembly would condemn hanging of a Bangladeshi criminal by a Bangladeshi court under Bangladeshi laws. For Pakistan, the hanging of Mullah was a reminder that there is a dark history that it has tried to bury. Stories it has not allowed its post-1971 generation to know. Secrets it doesn't want it to rise to the surface. But Bangladesh is not obliging. The war crimes trials are bringing this chapter in the subcontinent's recent history out into the open. The testimonials by the victims, the survivors, have laid bare the cruelties that the Bengalis of Bangladesh suffered. Abdul Qadir Mullah's hanging on 12th December instantly and unsurprisingly brought forth voices of strong condemnation in Pakistan. The Jamaat-e-Islami Pakistan, enraged at the execution, said it had got one more martyr and that the hanging was an acid test of faith, an interpretation of Islam and martyrdom not shared in Bangladesh. Similar groups in Pakistan even claimed that the execution was carried out at India's behest. While the Pakistani parliament passed a resolution, its foreign office tried to use a fig leaf to hide its embarrassment by saying that Mullah's hanging was an internal matter of Bangladesh. The Pakistani parliamentary resolution urged Bangladesh not to reopen wounds. Pakistan itself did not even initiate proceedings against the 195 Pakistani military officers whom Bangladesh wanted it to try for war crimes. This debate, if it gains momentum among the people of Pakistan, would be an extremely difficult situation for the establishment, that is the army. The genocide kept under wraps has a way of popping up even after decades. The Hamidur Rahman Commission report, published in 1974 but stayed classified for 30 years in Pakistan, documented how the Pakistani army conducted the execution of intellectuals, soldiers, businessmen, and supervised the mass burial. The Hamidur Commission, set up by Zulfikar Ali Bhutto, recommended that the Pakistani government set up a special court to investigate misconduct by the army. That never happened in Pakistan. If Sheikh Hasina is re-elected as Prime Minister, will the new government in Bangladesh ask Pakistan to reopen investigations? If Pakistan can talk of old wounds, so can Bangladesh. Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, in a tough retort, condemned the Pakistan Assembly resolution and said that corroborators of the genocide had no place in Bangladesh. Hundreds of Bangladeshi activists hit the streets protesting against Pakistan's resolution and even gave a call for the boycott of Pakistani-made goods. The Cable Operators Association of Bangladesh declared that they would take off Pakistani television channels in Bangladesh. Activist and daughter of a freedom fighter, Rubina Yasmin, said that Pakistan's resolution was ridiculous.
পাকিস্তানের পার্লামেন্টে আমাদের দেশ নিয়ে কথা হবে আমাদের সংবিধান নিয়ে কথা হবে এটা আমরা কখনোই মানব না আমরা মুক্তিযোদ্ধা সন্তানরা সারা বাংলাদেশের মুক্তিযোদ্ধা সন্তানরা রাজপথে আমরা মিছিলে মিছিলে স্লোগানে স্লোগানে
Wife of a 1971 war victim, Shamali Nazreen Chaudhary, condemned Islamabad's reaction over the execution of Qadir Mullah. She said Pakistan had always been against Bangladesh.
We have realized that if Jamaat-e-Islam is here, if they live in Bangladesh, they are in, if they are, they can live in Bangladesh, Bangladesh will never rise, Bangladesh will be destroyed. And you know that Pakistan is supporting them, and Pakistan, in Pakistan Parliament, they they took there were discussion about Qader Mullah's punishment, and this is they said different comments about Bangladesh. They are against Bangladesh. We protest it, we object to it, and this is they cannot do it, and we want that Bangladesh should be free from these Jamaat Islami. We do not want them. They should be punished, and they should be banned. They should not be allowed to do politics. They should not be allowed to remain in Bangladesh.
Abdul Quader Mollah had been convicted for the beheading of a poet and raping of an 11-year-old girl and shooting 344 people during the Liberation War of 1971 and another mass killing which earned him the title of Butcher or Koshai of Mirpur.
We want that all the war criminals should be tried and they get same kind of punishment, because during Liberation War, these war criminals, they were all engaged in war crimes. They killed thousands and thousands of people, and they killed them brutally. And my husband was a doctor, eye specialist, Dr. Alim Chowdhury, and he loved his country very much. He worked for freedom fighting, and other intellectuals also, they all loved their country and they all were patriots, and they worked for the liberation war. And that is why these people, these Jamaat Islami people, these Al-Badars, Rajakars, they worked for Pakistani army, and they took away all the people from home and in during curfew time, and then they took them in killing ground and they killed them brutally. I have seen my husband's dead body, and I cannot bear it. Till now, when I think about it, I feel very so sad. I am very sad about it, and all the martyred intellectuals were killed like that, and these Jamaat Islami, these Al-Badars, these Rajakars, they did it. So we will not get any peace in our mind if one of them can escape this punishment. They should be tried, they should get this death punishment.
Veteran Bangladeshi journalist Shari Al-Kabir, who has been relentless in the fight to bring war criminals to book, has hailed the execution of Mullah.
The implementation of the capital punishment of Qader Mullah, one of the main perpetrators of genocide of 1971, Bangladesh has come out from the culture of impunity. As we know that just after the Liberation War, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman's government started trial of the war criminals and perpetrators of the genocide of 1971. Unfortunately, after his brutal assassination in 1975, General Ziaur Rahman assumed power and he stopped the trial, and he released all the war criminals and the perpetrators of genocide and crimes against humanity who were in jail and who were imprisoned and who were facing the different kind of punishment. But since then, the civil society, the family of the victims of the war, they're demanding the trial and punishment for the perpetrators of genocide and the crimes against humanity. After 42 years, we have seen that one of the main perpetrators of Bangladesh genocide has faced the trial and his capital punishment was implemented. And this will help to come out from the culture of impunity we have seen in different countries where genocide have been taken in the last centuries. many countries, many victims of the war, many victims of the genocide, they are waiting for justice, waiting for trial of the perpetrators of genocide. And Bangladesh has set up an example. Through this trial, Bangladesh has given a clear message that any country can try the perpetrators of genocide with its own law in its domestic, in the domestic tribunal. So this could be an example for other countries, other people, other victims who are waiting for justice. They will be inspired to set up such trial court and to try the perpetrators of genocide. And that is the very positive thing Bangladesh has done.
Mullah was hanged at Dhaka Central Jail after due process of law. Normally, a convicted criminal awaiting execution is given a week's duration to seek clemency from the president of the country. But since Mullah was tried by the war crimes tribunal, he was not given this option.
3 million people were being killed during the liberation war of Bangladesh. And family members of those victims of war, those who had been tortured during the war, the rape victims, everybody was waiting for justice for the last 42 years. And now time has come to end the culture of impunity that we have seen for the last several decades in Bangladesh, that perpetrators of genocide, they were being pardoned. There were no justice, there were no trial of the war criminals and the crimes who committed crimes against humanity and genocide. So now the victims of the war, they feel at least a satisfaction that, well, justice had been delivered, though it was too late. But justice delayed doesn't mean justice denied. We have waited for 42 years. Now we have seen the trial, we have seen the justice. Now the victims of the war, they're demanding for the trial of the Jamaat-e-Islami, the party that is responsible for genocide, crimes against humanity and war crimes during the liberation war of Bangladesh. Those individuals who are facing trials, indeed they were very much involved in the killing of the common people, innocent people, but it is a Jamaat-e-Islami, the politics of Jamaat-e-Islami, that created a ground for genocide, that justified genocide in the name of religion, in the name of Islam. 3 million people were killed in Bangladesh in the name of Islam. And that's why this type of political party that promotes terrorism, that promotes killing innocent people in the name of religion, that should be banned. And we have seen after the Second World War, Nuremberg Tribunal banned Nazi party in Europe. So that is the model we are pressing our government to start trial of Jamaat-e-Islami as a criminal organization, as an organization that commits genocide, that promotes terror, and that promotes killing in the name of religion.
Meanwhile, justice seekers and campaigners of war crimes trial have been demanding a law for the protection of witnesses and victims. The Jamaat and the Chhatr Shibir cadres have been systematically targeting them to prevent the trial of other war criminals. Over 100 Jamaat Shibir activists have been arrested for looting and arson in the run-up to the elections next week. Before we leave you, here's a news roundup section.
A fire swept through a garment factory in Sawar on December 26th, damaging fabric and machinery. Reports said at least 3 people were injured in the incident. Police said the fire originated on the top floor of the 6-story Japan Bangla garments factory, but the cause is unknown. 4 global retailers, along with manufacturers and labor groups, have decided to set up a $40 million compensation fund for victims of the terrible Rana Plaza disaster that killed 1,135 people. Retailers like Primark, Loblaw and Bonmarsh have promised to contribute to the fund following the collapse of the garment factory complex in April. Police have arrested opposition leaders and workers after the opposition's declaration of a march for democracy towards Dhaka for December 29th. The joint forces of the Rapid Action Battalion and the Border Guard Bangladesh arrested 203 opposition members in 9 districts. A policeman was killed and another sustained burn injuries as some people set fire to a police bus at Bangla Motor in Dhaka on December 26th. The driver of the bus and a civilian also suffered burn injuries. Police have arrested BNP leader Mehboob-uddin Khokon from Dhaka. Dhaka Metropolitan Police have confirmed the arrest but refused to divulge details on the charges against the MP from Noakhali 1 constituency. A Bangladesh Army Infantry Battalion will leave for South Sudan soon to join the peacekeeping mission in the conflict-hit African nation at the request of the UN Secretary-General Ban Ki-moon. Officials have said that about 1,000 troops were expected to join the mission in South Sudan.
That's all we have for you this week. Thank you for watching Bangladesh Today and wish you a very happy New Year.